Hello there, viewers. How are you doing? Hopefully you're doing well. It is now time for me to see where I can actually plow and create a field. It is late in the day as well as late in the season. It's March. So, really, I haven't got much time, to be honest. Looks like I'm still plowing here. Lower regions is paid for now, cultural. Just taking way too long. Plowing always does in this game. Just takes way too long. And of course, I have to try and line it up where I started. Get the middle done. Is it even working? I think it is. Where was I before? Was I over there? I can't tell. Yes, I was. I was over there. Right, that's okay then. What is going on here? The grass is not vanishing properly in some stages. And I need to get my crops in the actual ground. If I miss a season where I don't actually grow anything, yeah, fine, fair dues. At least I've actually ploughed out a field, so when it comes to the snow season, it'll snow up, freeze the ground, destroy the actual ploughed areas. I'll just take the cultivator over it. It's bigger. And it's actually quicker at doing things. So I can actually go from there and actually do things right. So you could say I'm going to be setting up next season now. Because I still need to do work on the actual other field. I need to, of course, get it fertilized. And I've actually noticed the snow destroys some of the field and turns it back to grass. So when a cultivator goes over it again, it stays as grass, not as a field. I don't know why, but it just does. And it's kind of annoying when something reverts back to normal when it shouldn't, because it just leaves dots scattered everywhere, which means you need more time to go over them dots to get it back to how it's supposed to be. And of course, as you can see here, turning isn't really that great. Just needs a wider plow, to be honest. But I'm going to just be doing this, and I think that's what I'll be actually doing for the remainder of this year, is getting this field sorted out and the other field for next year. And in the meantime, I can do other things. I've got tobacco growing, so I can do the last entry in the journal, and then I can move on with whatever bottle comes next. Well, it is raining. It is May. I have got about 4 hours left for the tobacco to be... 5 hours for the tobacco to be pretty grown and ready to harvest. As you can actually see here, I've completed the field. It is now 100% fertilized. I'm just doing the last preparation checks. Basically doing a vision, have a look around, and then go on from there. It looks all green so far. If it turns out there's a few spots that are amber or red, at least I can take care of them. Oh, arigato. At least I can take care of them now, because of the fact that I have got animals and I can gather manure now. So, the missus has gone to work. I don't know how many animals will actually fill the actual animal boxes at the moment. So, two were left over from there. But open that. And let's go ahead and open up you. I finished building this one and painted it white. So, this one should open up this way. And you open that way. And you should open up this way. So, you two will come out this way. So this housing is actually full at the moment, which is alright. There we go. Shut you. Let's open you up. Open you up. And you will come out this way. There you go. At least this way they won't actually get caught on things. So that is two sheep. I have, of course, got a mare and a horse. Which one are you? A horse. Alright. Got a goat. And a sheep here. I might. Yeah, actually, wait a sec. Months. Eight. Ooh. You can't get pregnant because, well, you won't survive the whole entirety of it, unfortunately. You will, so getting a ram will actually help out there, so get some more sheep coming. Alright, open up you. Got them chickens. Out you go. And of course you can come out this way. I'm actually glad. It looks like all the animals are clean. That's good. And apart from you, Fluffy. Not that mucky, though, to be honest. There we go. And you up. There we go. No eggs. Right. What about the trough? The trough is full, so that's fine. Alright, you go that way then. And you as well. Alright, so you open. You open. So get you out. Get you out. Come out this way. Come on. Seriously, why do you... I don't get the pathfinding. I really don't. Yeah, it's still leading. Right, you walk off, do your own thing. You walk off, do your own thing. Let me clean you out. There we go. I've got another sheep in there. Wow, I've got too many sheep. Right. Okay. You're just going to stand there. All right then. Fine. I'll shut that gate on you. And let's open you up. And open you up. F. And F. And then go out this way because it's the clearing. One sheep out. And the bull does the exact same thing as the cow. Seriously, dude. Right. Put you in there. There you go. Right, You. What are you playing at, Carl? Come on. This way. Come on. Come on, follow me. Oh, you're out. Good. Sheesh. All I want to do is muck you out and get your lovely droppings. Come on, bull. There you come. If you have to be teleported, you'll have to be teleported. There you go. Thank you. And, yep. Food is fine here. Goodness me. Alright. Sorry, goat. Alright. And that's the buck. Right, where's the goat gone? I might just go down and get a ram, because I've got quite a few sheep. Right, here we go. 1 month. Alright then. Right, I need to chuck you into here and get the bucket. Here we go. Fill you up. Get rid of you. And let's take you, because you're... No, I'll leave you there, actually. I was just about thinking about selling you. Alright. At least I'm actually just showing you what I can do whilst I'm actually waiting for stuff. So basically, once this is actually fully fertilized again, I don't have to worry about having any negatives to the actual harvests. Can I even get everything in this throw? I do believe I can get everything. There we go. Yep. Perfect. Brilliant. That's good. Alright, come over here. The glare is a bit awkward. But yep, there you go. 100% fertilized everywhere now. And now there will not be a negative effect to any harvest that occurs on this field anymore. So snow can come over and then the cultivator can redo it. Make it easier. And over here, as you can actually see, of course, when I do the cultivating, I know which path to actually take. Because you can still see grass popping over and everything else. And if you actually look on the map, this area's huge. Right. So, follow this line. I'm in the forest. I cannot get rid of all this here. What's on the ground? So, that stays there. So, I can't really do any farming in this area. So, it's basically this area where I am now is up to this point here. So, from here in that direction is mine. As you can see, here to the left side is mine, and that's where our culture is. And then on the right side, I'm going to pay, but I'm going to be doing building. The forest is going to stay there, and there I will be just doing the building. And that's it. I'll be extending the actual farm out so I can have more animals on the farm. That's the main goal, or the main focus at the moment, is to have enough space for a large amount of animals. And then, of course, agriculturally will be in different segments. Going into here, this is basically the allotment, and I've actually put in beehives in this area as well as up here. I will be knocking this down and putting another fence from here going over here. So then this back bit will be for the animals. 1 hour. Right, so let's go into a town. There we go. And come back. I can harvest the tobacco. Right, I need to go to anyone wants to fight. I would like to go to the mayor. There we go. Hello there, mayor. Right, permissions for this area. It is agricultural because it's the most expensive, because there is more land than anything else here. So the more there is, it's going to be expensive in that area. So agricultural, thank you. And that'll be 4,000. But I can't buy that yet, because I need to buy the other products. As in materials, and of course, seeds to grow next year. Come on. Come on. Thank you. Down for the count. And thank you. All right. Let's go ahead and sell what I can here. There we go. So you don't need any stuff from you, so let's sell that. Thank you. The bread, can I sell? Yep, the bread as well. There we go. Brilliant. Right, now let's go back home, because I don't know what is actually going to officially happen now. Right, because once I've actually done the harvesting on this, there you go. That's done. I don't get anything for it, so no money. And I don't know what's next. I have to wait until the next day. And normally, I actually make something of an episode. Like, the wedding wasn't primarily about the wedding. The big harvest for the journal piece, what just has been completed, I did a harvest video on. That's it, 20. There we go. These aren't going to be touched anymore. Right, okay then. So basically, what I'm doing now is getting rid of the massive shrubs. Because unfortunately, the mower can't do anything with them. Cultivator can't, nor the plow. Apart from the scythe. There you go. And there we go. Right, so Cheryl is barren, of course. Can't do that here. All right. Actually, how big is this field? All right, shall we go to missions? Oh my goodness me, don't tell me. Really? Pass that rock. And yeah, I was right. So this field, oh my goodness me. All the way down to the river, all the way up to them trees is going to be my mobile field now for the fodder. Wow, I didn't know how big this field was. Oh, well, at least I'm going to get a lot of cut grass out of it. Blimey. A lot of small stones and big stones to be cleared. But a nice place. Cut it once a year. Obviously, I'll do it once the actual harvest has been sown in. And I can focus on this. It's definitely going to bring in its money's worth. Even if I did decide to put a field on here, I reckon I'll still get my money's back from just selling the cut grass and turning it into fodder. So keep it as it is, basically. Alright, there we go. I wish I could actually see the small stones by the actual supervision. Am I even on it? Ah, there you go. Bingo. It's done. I'm just going to go backs and forwards, aren't I? What's that? Excuse me. Something's there. A bucket. I don't know why a bucket's there. But anyhows, this is what I'm going to do, and I think I'll start mowing as well. Get the lights on. It is dark after all, and late. I just have to wait until the morning to see what a bottle brings me. Hopefully it's a bottle of joy. I need to count how many apple trees I've got and then go ahead and buy the rest up. I'm going to have N growing. And that's it. I reckon that'll be enough. So connect. And down. Nope. Forward. There we go. Right, still cutting third gear? Yes, I do. Oh my goodness me. Look at this. It's a cut-a-thon. Marvellous. Absolutely marvellous. Slow down. Oh. Lucky I didn't actually get that recognised, or that would have been me repairing a tractor. Right, not cutting yet. Not cutting yet. Cutting. Right. Let's get the lowest point of me cutting. Come on. And then I can go from there. Just, come on. No. Right. Stop there and go. There we go. Hopefully. No, nothing. What the heck? There it is. This is weird. I'm trying to find the actual cutting line. Alright, I think I've found it now. Difficult to get this tractor to stay straight. Yeah, there you go. I think I've got it. Perfect. Alright. Getting too dark for me to actually record, so I'm going to see you in the morning once I've got the bowl. Here we go! A bowl's been left! I had to log out and log back in to actually get this. Oh, horse riding, eh? You look like I got some horses in, innit? Okay then, so they say about you in the village that you must be a farmer after all. Well, Some people want to follow your example in the field. Do you know Blip? The one from the animals at the market. It's really getting on my nerves. I guarantee you that if I hear what kind of rider he is again, I won't stand it. Okay? They say you had a knack for horseback riding from a young age. Give that buffoon a lesson. Win the race with him. I'll tell you something interesting about your brother. Lost in the turmoil of war. Okay. That's kind of upsetting, really, to be honest. I've lost a brother from war. Oh, okay then. Well, that is in there. Now, the best part. If you come over here, as you can actually see, I have gone ahead and mowed everything and used the scythe on these, and these were removed, and now they're back. Don't know why they're back. I don't know if you can actually get rid of them apparently, but as you can actually see, it is all good. Can't do anything here. That's a shame. So all I have to do now is go ahead, pick up all these bales and put them into the cutter, so then I can actually create fodder, and then that fodder can be sold for profit. And I do believe, why is these bits here? There we go, they've gone. Yep, that's gone. I don't know why they've come back. But I do believe from now, all I'll be selling. Why is grass just all suddenly popping up from nowhere? Right, all I'll be selling is the honey that I gather, the apples that I harvest, and of course the fodder from all them bales. But for now, I could just say this episode is all about getting that field sorted out. Of course, I need money to progress with my plan of having the other side over there as a building area. That whole area is now agricultural, but it's only for grass cutting and going into the cutter and making fodder, and that's it really. So we know now what to do next, and that is run a race against Philip, and of course take some injections, which I can get from Tekla, but I've been actually winning them anyhows. So for this video, it's going to be the end of the video. So, yep, this is the end of the video. Thank you very much for watching. And remember, I appreciate you all. You'll see me in the next one. Bye.